why should I care about MLOps at all? It's really tempting to think of machine learning projects as quite different than software development projects. And that's because quite often the actual work of producing a predictive model is done by one person, and they're a data scientist, not a programmer. So why would I care about things like source control if there's only one person doing the work? Or even if there is a team, when you do your training runs, you're typically using a VM that lives somewhere else, a shared one. So why would I need to define the infrastructure if that's something that's over there? Well, in the many decades of software engineering, we've kind of landed on this idea of DevOps in the last couple. And there's a wealth of information out there and a wealth of research by people like Gene Kim and Dr. Nicole Forsgren that prove that there's some really tangible benefits to these good DevOps practices. In fact, the data suggests that a good DevOps practice, or an organization that has good DevOps practices, has much better outcomes when it comes to delivery of their software, and ultimately company-wide outcomes as well. So if we think about DevOps as the idea of getting value delivered continuously to your end users, MLOps is exactly the same thing. You're trying to produce a model and deliver value to your end users, which is undoubtedly a positive thing. What it ultimately means is, as a data scientist, you can focus on the real stuff that you are good at. So making the best predictive model you possibly can, and all the peripheral stuff like queuing training runs, worrying about infrastructure, and deploying that model to production. These all happen automatically in the background, and you are focused on what you are best at.